Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. Today I'm talking about expected value, and that represents the mean value of the outcomes. It's obtained by finding the value of the summation of the outcome times the probability of that outcome. So let's say you're told that you can play for a game for $5, and how the game works is you roll a dice, so there's six outcomes, 1 through 6, and if you roll a 1 or a 6, you get a 7. If you roll a 2, you get a dollar. And if you roll a 3, 4, or 5, you get $4. So the question is, can the owner of the game make a profit in the long run? What is the owner's expected payout? What's the player's expected value? So for the owner, when somebody rolls 2 outcomes or 2 out of 6 times, he's going to have to pay $7. Remember, he's getting $5 for you to play. Sometimes he has to pay out 7. One of those times, if there's a 2 rolled, 1 out of 6 times he pays a dollar. He makes $4. And 3 out of 6 times he pays back $4. So he makes $1. And if you add those together, which is what the summation symbol, that sigma symbol, is telling us to do, we add them all together, what we get is $4.50. This represents the average payout for a single roll. That means the owner can expect to make an average of 50 cents per roll. Now, he never actually pays back 450. Sometimes 7, sometimes 1, sometimes 4. This is the average amount that he can expect to pay out in the long run. So he's setting this game up so he's making essentially 50 cents every time somebody plays the game. But here's another way to think of it. What's the expected value for the player? If you roll a 1 or a 6, you make $2 because you paid $5 to play, but a 1 or a 6, you win $2. So you have a positive winning for that $2. And that happens 1/3 of the time, or 2/6, right? 2/6 is 1/3. If you roll a 2, you lose $4. But that only happens 1 out of 6 times. And if you roll a 3, 4, or 5, you lose $1 because you get $4 back, right? So you lose $1, and that happens half the time, 3 out of 6 times. So your expected value is 2 times 1/3. That's from this first line. And then -4 times 1/6. And then -1 times 1/2. So you're losing $1, you're losing $4, you're winning $2. And if you add those all together, your expected value is -50 cents. You can expect to lose 50 cents per roll. Of course, you never lose 50 cents. You sometimes lose 4, sometimes lose 1, sometimes win 2, but this is the average that we're looking at. Okay, next example. What is the expected value of a game where you have to choose a 4-digit number from the number 0 through 9, and if it costs $1.50 to play, and you get $90 if you choose the correct number. So you're choosing a 4-digit number. So whenever we choose numbers, because we're putting, you can repeat, like you could have 7777, right? So since we can repeat, the first number has 10 choices, 0 through 9. And then the second number has the same thing, 10 choices again. And the third number, we have 10 choices. And the fourth number, we have 10 choices. So we have 10 to the fourth power, or 10,000 different numbers to choose from. Makes sense, right? Because one of them is 0000, right? So we have 10,000 different numbers to choose, and only one of those will be the correct number. So if you win, you'd have the $90 that you're going to get, but you have to take the $1.50 off that you lost. So you might win $88.50. If you win the $90, you've won $88.50. That's your profit. And that would happen one time out of 10,000. So the probability of winning is 1 over 10,000, or 0.0001, 1 10,000th. So to figure out the expected value for this, you take what you're going to normally lose. So you normally are going to lose your money. $1.50, so -150. Times 9,999 times out of 10,000. Plus, every once in a while, one time out of 10,000, you could win $88.50. And so if you add those two together, you get -$1.49. So the expected value here is -$1.49. You're not going to win very often. Most of the time, you're going to lose. Any game with an expected value of negative 1.49 would be equally risky to play. So it could be that there's three numbers, a three-digit number, but you're only choosing from seven, or there's a nine-digit number, but you're choosing from whatever. If the expected value is negative 1.49, that would have the same risk, regardless of what the game looks like. All right, we'll do another expected value in the next video. Have a great day.